Once upon a time, long ago, in a rich palace, lived a handsome king and his beautiful young wife, Marigold. Everyone loved Queen Marigold, for she was as kind and good as she was lovely. One afternoon in winter, when the sun was shining low over the pure white snow, the queen was seated at her window, sewing. Suddenly, she pricked her finger. A drop of blood fell onto the snow on the windowsill. She sighed.
Oh, how I wish I could have a child, a daughter, with lips as red as blood, with hair as black as the ebony on the sill. And a complexion as smooth and clear as the purity of the snow. If I could have such a child, I would call her Snow White.
Nine months later, just as the Queen had wished, a baby daughter was born. The child was beautiful, with lips as red as blood, hair as black as ebony, and a complexion as smooth and clear as the snow. The child was named Snow White. But alas, 6 weeks later, Queen Marigold was dead. After mourning for some time, the king took another wife. Queen Wibulina was also very beautiful, but vain and spiteful too.
Thank you. flowers. No trouble to move on my account. I think it's such a nice day, there's nothing to do but enjoy it. Have you ladies had your lunchtime P5 class yet? You must keep at it. Come on, everybody. Knees, bears. Knees, bend. I think those with the widest waist should begin first.
Brent has gone jogging 3 times round the courtyard and 1 round the marsh brush. Look, here she goes.
To be a king in 16C is a very jolly thing to do. I have a man of servants' heart, as you have surely seen.
The Queen! She must have finished
looking for you everywhere. I need my consort to be around when I desire my wishes to be attended. I can't imagine what you've been doing in here. What are your socks up there? I must have a word with you about the behaviour of some of the staff. Some of the insubordination is quite intolerable. I have just seen a goose rushing off into the woods, waving a butterfly net and a wooden spoon, and shouting, cock-a-doodle-doo!
How extraordinary! You don't know what people will get up to these days.
Arranging our great banquet for next year. I've invited all the most important people. And I've ordered a new gun. Well, actually two. I couldn't make up my mind whether red satin or black would offset my features the most.
Black, I should think.
Each gown was under the 5,000, so I could easily wear one of the others at some other protection. I shall, of course, require some more jewels. Rubies, yes, rubies, I think.
Snow White should have a new gown, too.
Snow White? Snow White is merely a child. She may retire to bed early. She can borrow my portable toilet. That ain't her problem. Oh, here she comes now.
Snow White, my love, are you well? Why go you to your bedchamber so early?
My stepmother, Queen Wibbelina, says it's my bedtime.
And it's only 7 o'clock. On this Coronation Street.
She needs her sleep.
But she's nearly 17.
I insist! I'm her mother now. You must not question my authority. Now, run along, you two. I have some business to attend to.
Thank you. what he did with his rattle. Oh dear, my little half-brother can be a handful, I know. Where's his mother? I don't know, but I know one thing. I shall definitely ask for an increase in wages. He'll engage money in this job. Young and disciplined princes, not like they used to be. I don't know what the younger generation's coming to. But he's such a bad influence with the other occupants of the nursery. Oh gracious, here they come
on the national health. then, Mother?
Yes, I know all about him. Into everything he is, chinking it commodity. But what can you expect with a mother like that? Marry our Queen, and marry that beautiful blonde princess from the next country. You remember her, Archibald?
Ah, I remember her. I remember her.
Thank you.
although you have the fairest face, today it is a real disgrace. You are looking queer somehow. Snow White is the bestest now. Her eyes are bright, her skin is fair. Her breath is light, the gentlest air. Her toes are dainty, slim her waist. And above all, her mind is chaste. I shall warn you, Ruby dear, and this I make abundantly clear. If you harm me, glass or frame, it will be an awful shame. For you, never more will know if your beauty fresh will grow.
Thank you.
I want you to take your princess, Snow White, into the woods. Into the woods.
And?
And?
You did that!
Thank you.
arrivederci a Roma. You like your abbecchio?
I like it.
Thank you.
stress, those prickly things can cause a mess.
What was that noise I thought I heard?
Fireflies dancing in the sunset. I shan't be afraid of fireflies.